everybody, it's Dr. Joe, and it's anatomy time. And guess what? We're going to talk about the lumbar spine today. Let's get started. Disclaimer alert, disclaimer alert. So the folks at GPI Anatomicals were very nice and they sent me some of their models. This is a normal spine. So I'm just going to show you some pieces here so you can see what I'm talking about. And if you look at it, it looks nice and healthy. The bone looks smooth all the way around. Your disc in here is nice and circular. The nucleus pulposus is in there. And that's kind of that squishy part of the spine. And when it's not doing well, it bulges out. Here is your nervous system, your central spine, your central nervous system. And then these are the nerves that come out. So if they were here, those would be the ones going out to my legs. And then you've got your spinous process in the back. And so you can see here, there's lots of nice space. So it's not pushing on the nerves. It's not pushing on the nerves going out here. You can see maybe the little bumps here. Those are the nerve roots. And so a lot of times if you have the radiculopathy, that's where the nerve root is inflamed because something is pushing on it here and it's shooting out that pain to your leg, or if it's in the cervical spine out to your arms. So as you can see, these all look good. This is how it's supposed to look. But unfortunately, even at an early age, we start degenerating and changing and things start happening over time. So then the next one over would be here. And so you can see a little bit of changes up on top. It shows you a herniated disc where it's just bulging a little bit. It's not actually ruptured and pushing all the way through, but it's gonna start putting a little pressure there. Now, a lot of times with a herniated disc, you're not gonna have any symptoms because it's not quite pushing on the spine. But what might happen is you might bend over to lift something up and it puts just enough pressure just to give that twinge where you're like, oh my goodness. But it's not a constant kind of pain yet. You can also see here where it might start pushing out and irritating that nerve and nerve root a little bit. So at some point when it's bulging, if it's big enough, it might start giving some pain going out there. And so you can see that there's just some minor changes here at the bone, some degeneration and stuff. And so that's when it's not terrible. A lot of us after the age of 25, 30 start having these changes, but we just don't have any symptoms until we have either something that triggers it or we twist the wrong way and it just hits that spot. So then after that, it starts getting a little bit worse as we age some more, or maybe we do actually have an injury. And then you can see here where the disc is actually ruptured through. And this is when it starts to get to that point where you might have your leg feeling like it's constantly asleep because it's pushing on that nerve here, or it's pushing out at the sides here. And then you just feel that burny feeling, that sharp pain, pins and needles. A lot of times people say it feels like their foot's going to sleep. But the scary part when it's pushing on the nerves is that nerve is not getting that signal to the muscles like it's supposed to. So then a lot of times when your brain says, lift your toes up because I'm walking, it's delayed because it's not going like it's supposed to. And you go to step and you catch your toes and you stumble down. So that's when it becomes a scary issue and you really need to go to your doctor, go to your physical therapist and figure out what you can do to start getting that better. And you can even see here on the bone, like something right there would be a bone spur, and those can cause a lot of pain and irritation, especially if they're over around where those nerve roots are coming out. So you can even see right here where the disc itself is getting smaller because you're just degenerating and it's pushing down and causing pressure. And when the disc gets smaller, the space out here, then it becomes a spinal stenosis issue where that it's the narrowing, and then that actual narrowing of the bone is pushing out on those nerves. And so that's why then people start bending over more, because it opens up those spaces to take some pressure off of it. And then you have here the really scary one that you don't really want to see. And this is when it becomes where it's a full stage osteoporosis. And you can see here, you can barely see the disc space in between here because everything's just kind of collapsed. There's not even really the nucleus pulposus in there. And so that's when everything's degenerated. people are really, really bent over trying to get that pressure off of it, or they just don't have the stability of the spine anymore and it just starts degenerating away. And that's when it becomes really scary, because as it goes down, it pushes on all those nerves and then things stop working how they're supposed to. So that just kind of shows you, you can see right there that disc has been pushed all the way out into the nerve. And so that's when it becomes very tough. But the thing is, it's not a, okay, I have to get up and not, sit down and not get up anymore and do anything, because with exercises, with stretches, with the right kind of therapy, you can do those kind of things, and actually exercising helps this. So go talk to your doctor, go talk to your physical therapist, find out what you need to do so you don't have to just sit down and not have a quality of life anymore. So there you got, have it. There, all of them here. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section. If you'd like to check out some other videos, go to AskDoctorJo.com. And remember, be safe, take care of your spine, have fun, and I hope you feel better soon.